combination of two Latin words, hook and cure, which means care anywhere. If you know what Slack or WhatsApp is or what Twilio is, Hucu is like Slack, WhatsApp, Twilio combo for healthcare. It's a person-centered messaging first of its kind and gives you real-time patient risk in real time. So our team is, and I'm forwarding moving slides. So if anybody feels that I'm stuck, please let me know so I can jump in and correct it. So myself, I formed CareMerge. My co-founder Laura exited and formed Autism Home Support Services. And then we have Brian Kelly on sales and marketing side, a serial entrepreneur, and Mudassar Ali, co-founder. He helped me on building the Hucu HIPAA compliant architecture. So what Hucu is trying to solve is like these clinical communication that goes on between different healthcare workers. And it's one-on-one communication, and it's everywhere and nowhere. This results into disorganized communication, results into a lot of hospitalizations. And then frontline workforce is very transient workforce, so there is really no quantifiable way to hold them accountable. So how Hucu solves these three problems is by simply giving them a single tool. So instead of emails, faxes, phones, they just use Hucu. And they communicate in a very patient-centered, discussion-specific type of communication. As they communicate, we get structured, unstructured data, and our algorithms prioritize that patient list for them so they know who to reach out to or which patients are at higher risk. As people collaborate, our other set of algorithms start to give them Hucu honors, which signifies how effectively they're communicating or how fast they're responding or how timely they're responding and how valuable information they're sharing. So this helps everybody to see who are good collaborators, who are not so good collaborators. The app is very simple. It's iOS, Android based. And then we also have a web version. It has these patient channels, as you can see on the left-hand side. And then a patient, when you go into a patient channel, you can bring in different people from different organizations. They can communicate. And there's also a family patient messaging mode. So all the collaborators, clinicians, they can actually go to the family side or the patient side and see what's been taught. So we've been growing pretty fast and effectively. We launched in April of last year, right at the top of pandemic. And this is how we addressed the pandemic response. So one of the things we did is we already have a great messaging technology. We partnered with Zoom. So now you can have one-touch telehealth enable. We integrating with different labs. So as lab results come, we push that lab result to physicians who are ordering and then patients. We are obviously helping people, especially in skilled nursing facilities, which are completely locked down, to have the staff communicate with families and everybody else. And then we have a Hucu plugin. So this is where you can plug in Hucu to coordinate care through your technology if you're a healthcare provider. And then there are several different valuable things as part of the response to COVID-19 we have as part of Hucu. The most exciting thing is, because different people are collaborating, we can create a patient journey over time to see what really happened to the patient or where. We also have robotic process automation, which has increased collaboration over 800%. In essence, Hucu is really the first of its kind messaging platform. Our pricing is PMPM, and it's free, unlimited. So you can invite anybody on Hucu for free if you are a subscriber. So far, we have about 55 contracts. As I mentioned, we launched in April of last year, and we are approaching already 100,000 in the end of this quarter. We have about 15,000 total contracts with about 1,000 users. And what we are looking for here is, if you're a provider, you can join hundreds of other providers using Hucu. With payers, we are happy to go at risk with you. For technologies, they can embed Hucu and simplify messaging. And we are in the process of closing our 1 million convertible note. So happy to answer any questions anybody has at this time.
Can you tell us, you quickly talked about robotic process automation. I don't think everybody knows what that is. Can you say a little bit more about what that is and how it's impacting patient care?
Yeah, so robotic process automation is the system knowing, the messaging app knowing who to notify without even the person who's sending the message knowing who should I reach. So a perfect example is a lot of our customers are in skilled nursing facilities and they are, you know, caring for patients in skilled nursing. Facilities have a lot of these, you know, transient workforce. So if I'm a nurse that's come from agency on a part-time basis at night and something is going on with this patient, I don't know who to call. I don't know what their phone number is. I just don't know. But what I do is I message in that patient channel about this patient condition, we know who to reach out to for that specific message based on that. So we automatically pull in the right doctor or a nurse practitioner or whoever it is that we have identified to jump in and help that nurse at that time very effectively. So that's one very simple example. And that has actually increased the collaboration by over 800% with one of these clients' data that I'm sharing. Can you see my screen with the 8X plus?
Yep. Yeah, we see it. That's awesome. That's a great example that you just shared. So you've got a lot of opportunity in front of you. What type of organizations are you mainly targeting right now? How are you prioritizing the different areas of opportunity, and where do you see the most opportunity for growth and adoption?
Yeah, thank you. I think what we are seeing is Hucu is just like WhatsApp or Slack. It's a very versatile tool. So anybody in healthcare can use it. And that's what we are seeing. Our primary focus is where the need is the most, which is post-acute care. So a lot, 50 million plus seniors that aging segment is gonna continue to grow. And a lot of physicians and nurse practitioners, case managers, organizations that are trying to figure out social determinants of health, all those organizations are benefiting, and those are our targets. So primarily physician groups and nurse practitioners who are serving in this post-acute care world.
Are you able to quantify your outcomes and anything you can share in terms of the data there?
Yeah, I think one of the outcomes is, as you've seen, we are able to increase proactive collaboration by 8X. I mean, that's huge when people need somebody and they don't know who to reach. The system is automatically connecting them with the right person. So that's one big outcome. The subsequent outcome because of that is reduced hospitalization. So we have seen up to 20% decrease in hospitalizations through robotic process automation, those notifications went. Some other outcomes that we have seen are staff quality of life. There's a big deal about physician burnout and how they're trying to coordinate all the care for patients everywhere. So we have seen significant improvements in lesser burnout because Hucu is super organized by location, by patient, and their day-to-day communication.